tricky question. And it was a tricky question because there are two things involved. First of all, this is one reason it's a tricky question. There are two things involved in testing when you're reading the results. The first thing is, how likely is it that you will get the same result as you got from your sample? Yeah? And the second thing is, what variation is there likely to be between the results when you roll out after you've tested and what you got in the test? And so there are tables. There is actually some tables in my book which show you the exact numbers that you need to do when you're testing. You know, the problem then becomes more complicated because before you start, you have to make a decision, which is what sort of percentage do I expect to get when I do my test? Yeah? So you have to use your judgment on a commodity in very short supply. So the higher the response rate you expect to get, then the smaller the number you need. And the greater the amount of variation you're willing to accept between your test and your roller. Have I got you? Are you with me? I don't understand. I'll tell you what I'm really good at. I'm really bloody stupid, yeah? So I got a guy who worked for me over in Mayo to explain it to me. I said, if I can understand it, I can explain it to anyone. Yeah? It's my secret weapon, stupidity, and I'm not kidding. Yeah? And I sat and thought, because I was writing about it. How do I explain it in simple words, yeah? But yeah, you need those tables. Now, the other element is that you don't just run a test and then say, we've got the results, that's it. For some freakish reason, known only to God, if he exists, sometimes your test doesn't repeat the way you think it would. So you have to repeat your test. You don't just do your test and then roll it out. Yeah? But the biggest mistake people make when testing is to draw lunatic conclusions from small numbers. I remember there was a guy who worked for me in Dover who used to run around the world on the American Express account. We never knew where he was. He was a man of bloody mystery. I eventually discovered he had a very complex emotional life. And I remember standing up at a seminar at Ogilvy and standing up and saying, so we did this test and therefore it did so and so. And when he finished, I said, so you're full of shit, Yost. You know? I said, it proved nothing of the sort. It proved that for that sample, which is not big enough, you got such and such a result. You don't understand. I don't understand numbers, but I learned bloody quickly that to succeed in this business, you better understand the numbers. Yeah, you better understand the numbers from every point of view. I'm in the middle of trying to write three books, and one of them is a very short version of Common Sense, which goes on. Common Sense is great for propping up stable doors, and you know. So I'm writing something which I think will be just called No Nonsense Marketing. And I've been trying to put it into different chapters. And one of the chapters is just going to be about numbers. Because there are so many interesting things about numbers. You know? Like, for instance, that if you take a number that's very odd, it's more likely to get people's response than if you take a, you know, and so on. There are many, many things. It's a numbers game.